That's what I looked when we had a few hundred square feet. My hair's still brown, but it's on the inside.
This is way back when it started. If you notice the computer in the background, that is now a boat anchor somewhere.
That's one computer there and cutting edge.
Fax machine.
And if you look close, you might find the Rolodex, which I happen to still have on my desk.
And that is what the packing area looked like.
Yeah, well, this is back in the day. That was, Bill, you recognize that because you worked in that one. And that was at the
617.
So we had one table to make kits and one table to ship orders and two bags.
Get one back.
Why don't you guys pick up the rest of from here?
That was Anna's back there, no?
There she is. Is that Ellipse or is that Southeast Central?
That's Central. You guys were packing.
To move to?
Move to, well, we got a couple packing. Show you guys how I wish that we would have been able to move like this from Ellipse over here, but we kind of did. I do remember loading stuff in my truck. Loaded to the gills.
Juan, is that the truck that you drove through the garage door with at Ellipse?
Yes. The first time.
At 6 in the morning?
Times.
Speak up. I can't hear you.
That was the first time, but I did it was a few times.
Oh, you did it a few times.
And this is the home that we moved to.
And we actually put those letters up ourselves, didn't we? We took the glue and put it up. That's Ellipse before we moved in. It used to be a race team, and wasn't some of the people from Patron was over there?
Yeah, the old Patron racing team people were there prior to us.
We did have to get a lot of oil off the...
Oil and lights.
Yeah, like
we must have had like
those people connected to those race teams. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Right there. Yeah.
Hey, look at that.
He did tell me to back it up.
Just saying.
I was following an order.
And he still listens.
He just didn't open the door all the way.
And he still listens to me.
I think we all know that guy up there on the makeshift scaffold.
That was John Cool, wasn't it?
Yep, that was John. It
John
looks like.
Keen. About 50 pounds lighter.
Setting the store up, setting the offices up. I remember that office. That was a dark, cramped little office. We had how many people inside there at one time?
Four.
It was there was more than that. When Penny and I came on, there was like five or six in that little room. All right. Now we go from the one place to another. This is when this place where you're at right now wasn't even a... Well, it's kind of reality. It started clearing the ground, pouring the concrete. I really should have made these pictures bigger. I guess that's conduit for all the wiring.
Yes.
And that was pretty cool to see, is watching them drop those walls in, or these walls in, I should say. You know, the prefab came in, set them up. How they all stayed up, I don't know. And this is where the offices are. Actually, that looks like where the conference room is at right now.
Yes, it is.
The skeleton. The angry silver spiders, that's what I remember.
Yeah, these are the first six bays.
Yes. Then that was a fun day, moving all that around. If you thought it was noisy that one day when we were moving around in the back, you should have been here that day. Setting the bays up. Oh.
Look at that hair.
I had hair back then. Wow. This was our first bay, which Mike and I may remember. You could barely move in that place. And it started as a photo studio and turned into a actual studio where we had our first class. Remember that, Mike? I was taking, as you can tell up on the top, well, you can't see it on this picture. Up on the top, I was actually shooting over the wall because there was no ceiling, so that way I could get the shot because the walls were too close, so I actually had to go up on a ladder on the back side of the wall to get some shots.
And actually, the first time I saw Mike do a class, I was up on the ladder overlooking that, watching you do that class that day.
Then we moved over into here, which would be that half over there. Then we transformed it one more time. And now we transformed it into this, which this was our I think it was the season end. No, this was the premiere of Competition Ready. And there is the overview site. Danielle might remember this. I remember the big confusion there for the longest time was what we were going to call ourselves when we were thinking about buying .com. We were .net, put it on the building. Bob had an idea. Let's take that down. And let's add .com. So this building and this company has definitely been through some changes. It has went through a progression of things. I think all of them for the better. We've always saw our competitors out there, shot them down one by one, ended up taking them over and getting to be where we're at now. And here is a little memento for you, Bob.
Bob McKee here, and you found me in one of my favorite places behind the wheel of my newborn motor coach.
I took off for a weekend last month just to try and recall the whole year. All of the faces and all of the places, wondering where they all disappeared. I didn't ponder the question too long. I was hungry and went out for a bite. Ran into a chum with a bottle of rum and we wound up drinking all night. It's those changes in latitudes, changes in attitudes. Nothing remains quite the same. All of our running and all of our cunning, if we couldn't laugh, we would all go insane. Reading departure signs in some big airport reminds me of the places I've been. Visions of good times that brought so much pleasure makes me want to go back again. If it suddenly ended tomorrow, somehow adjust to the fall. Good times and riches and son of a bitches, I've seen more than I can recall. These changes in latitudes, changes in attitudes, nothing remains quite the same. Through all of the islands and all of the highlands, if we couldn't laugh, we would all. Just dream of it.